Welcome to a Stanford Medicine 25 video on venous testing using a Doppler.
Okay, so the handheld Doppler can also be a useful tool for interrogating the venous system of the patient. Individuals may come to the office frequently with swelling in their lower extremities, and one of the things you have to think about is, does this person have deep venous thrombosis? Does this person have venous insufficiency? And there are some things that you can do at the bedside with a handheld Doppler. And in the foot, you basically listen over the posterior tibial, in this case, and the vein, of course, the posterior tibial vein is running adjacent to the posterior tibial artery. And you can hear the posterior tibial artery signal. You can't hear the venous signal unless you do an intervention. And the intervention is compression to increase venous return. So take a listen now to the arterial signal and watch what happens when I compress the foot. What you just heard was venous return being augmented by compression of the foot. And that tells you that at least in this immediate vicinity, the venous return is normal. There's no obstruction. You want to move up the leg do the same thing over the popliteal space. Listen for the popliteal artery, and again do compression, this time of the calf, and you should hear a robust signal, venous signal, if the individual has an open venous system. So, to complete the venous examination, you have to move up the lower extremity. And you'd want to do the same thing that I just showed you at the foot. You'd want to do that over the popliteal space. Listen for the popliteal artery signal with your Doppler. And then, once you got that signal, then squeeze the calf, and you should hear a robust signal of venous return. And now you can do the same thing, and you'll do the same thing at the femoral artery. Put the Doppler probe over the femoral artery, hear a signal, and once you hear that signal, then you squeeze the thigh, and you should hear a nice venous augmentation. So that's checking for the patency of the veins in the lower extremity using a handheld Doppler. But you can also check for venous insufficiency as well. And in that case, you're doing the compression proximally and looking for venous insufficiency, venous flow distally. And so the way you do that is, again, you listen for that popliteal artery signal with your handheld Doppler. And of course, you got to get back into the popliteal space. And you really should have the patient, for this exam, you should have the patient turning over. The patient should be on their stomach to listen over the popliteal space. And in this case, the compression is going to be proximal to the handheld Doppler. So we're putting the Doppler over, the transducer over the popliteal space. We're listening for the popliteal artery signal. So we've put the transducer gel in the popliteal fossa. We've found the popliteal artery signal. And again, to check for patency of the veins, you compress distally. That prolonged roar you just heard was venous return, secondary to the compression of the calf. Let's try that again. Okay, did you hear that? Now, I'm going to look for venous insufficiency. If his valves are not patent, you'll hear the same kind of roar when I compress the thigh. If his valves are patent, you won't hear anything when I compress the thigh, but you might hear a little bit of an increase in venous return when I let go. So let's try that. Okay, I didn't hear much there. Now I'm going to release, and you hear a little bit of an increase in venous return.
This has been a Stanford Medicine 25 video on venous testing using a Doppler. Thanks for watching.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.